PowerPoint is particularly convenient for recording video with pictures, video clips, animation, pointer movement and drawings. It is very simple and you can easily change individual slides and add new information. Go to slideshow, record from current slide or from the beginning. Select your microphone and camera if you have several. Right-click on the slide to display pointer. Pointer has to be reselected on every new slide. Animation, a pointer and notes will be recorded in the slideshow. If you have notes, you can read them while recording a slideshow. Notes are also convenient for creating subtitles. YouTube can automatically synchronize your notes with your video for English language. Click on Notes in the top middle when you are in Record Slideshow mode. You can increase font size for your notes. You can turn camera on and off if you want to record just audio. I recommend always to record with video. You can move, resize and hide video object behind your graphic objects on any slides where you want to hide video and have only audio in your final slideshow. Start recording by pressing Record button or R on your keyboard. Stop recording by pressing Stop button or letter S. Pause and resume recording by pressing letter I on your keyboard or button pause. It will be displayed instead of record button once you will start your recording. After you have stopped recording, there will be a button to replay recorded fragment, or you can press V on your keyboard. Sometimes PowerPoint does not record a sound properly, so I recommend to recheck recording after each slide or every couple of slides, and at the end of your slideshow you can also check if the sound and video recorded correctly before saving your presentation in video format. For me, the most convenient way was to stop recording after each slide, then by pressing Alt plus Tab I switched application windows to my PowerPoint presentation in editing mode to read notes. For example, to ensure that I will read correctly and quickly terminology and Latin names, and that I will keep correct accentuations in sentences. Also, you need to place cursor in the note field to scroll your notes with the down arrow key, and place cursor outside of the notes area if you want to navigate slide recording with shortcuts or if you want to trigger animation. Here I show that there are two separate PowerPoint windows for recording and for editing your slides, and that you can switch between them with Alt plus Tab. If you want to have video from your camera at the same place on every slide, I suggest to insert rectangle as a placeholder on every slide. Rectangle dimension is shown on this slide. But you can also move and resize your video object. And as I told you, you can hide it behind the graphical object if you want to hide to have just audio on some of your slides. For example, if they have no suitable place to put video in. You can also set smooth transition between slides before saving your video. Transition is applied to individual slides, so you need to select all slides in your presentation if you want to have a uniform transition in your video. Save your file as MPEG-4 format video. Now you need to ensure that you preserve high video quality graphic format in your video. Press More option link. Select Tools, Compress Pictures, and ensure that High Fidelity Resolution is selected before saving your video in MPEG-4 format, as you see here. Also, I would like to share with you a couple of useful PowerPoint functions, which you may not know. Design templates in PowerPoint have different layouts, and you can select the most appropriate one if you right-click on slide. If you have multiple slides with similar layout, for example, with the same slide title, you can duplicate them with the shortcut Ctrl plus D. Layout may include placeholder for picture. This is convenient if you want to have a same size picture on all of your slides. You can either click on the middle of the placeholder picture placeholder to select the picture via file manager, or you can replace placeholder with the picture copied from the buffer. Note that your picture will be cropped to the size of the placeholder frame, so you can display the best part of your oversized picture by dragging it within the cropped area. You can hide those slides which you don't want to display in your video, but which you still want to include to Hangouts for your students. One interesting function in PowerPoint is called Design Ideas. Here, my initial slide had only text box, and this nice beetle image have been actually suggested me by PowerPoint. So the algorithm does read the and understand your slides. Design ideas are proposed for every slide with a relatively small number of objects, and you can select from many different options if you press Home and then Design Ideas. To generate handouts, you can print to PDF your slides with notes. You can also save slides in PDF format, but the best compromise between the file, the size of, and quality of your PDF file will be if you print your slides using Microsoft Print to PDF printer. If you want to save just notes from all slides, for example, for uploading subtitles to YouTube, you can select Note Page View and remove slides to leave only notes. And again, you can print note pages from all slides to PDF and export it then to Microsoft Word with Adobe Acrobat Pro, if you have Pro version, because it's not available in the free version. Unfortunately, there is no option to save directly from PowerPoint to Microsoft. In Microsoft Word, you can remove double paragraphs or blank lines and section breaks, and save the resulting text in TXT format for uploading subtitles to YouTube. If you know some other useful tricks on how to record video lectures with PowerPoint, please share it in comments. Thank you very much.